this movie is an emotional banquet. You feel so many things.
Listen, this is one of the greatest films ever made.
Adventure it up there!
Carl's in this place where he doesn't know what his life is about. As far as he's concerned, he had his great love, he had his great life.
Come along, boys!
And now he's just kind of winding down the clock.
We're on our way, Ellie.
This story is about Carl finding a new life without Ellie, which is something he didn't want to do, but it is what's before him. And that's part of grieving, is moving on. And so what Carl is learning through this experience and through this adventure, that it's time for him to live. You know, whatever you've lost, whatever person, you think that, well, that was it. There's nothing to look forward to now.
Ready?
There is.
Ready.
You probably don't see it yet, but it's there. And for those of you who are watching, who feel like you can't go on because of what or who you've lost, adventure is out there. The hope is out there. The life is out there. It's time to discover it.
Well, you did it, Pixar. You broke both of us.
Alan usually says it, but I'll say it. Damn you, Pixar.
Welcome to Cinema Therapy. My name is Alan Seawright. I'm a professional filmmaker who needs therapy. That guy.
Jonathan Decker, licensed therapist who loves movies. What are we doing today?
I'm going to have you react to a film, as you often do.
Which film are we doing?
What if I told you we were going to react to an entire saga of a married couple that only lasts 4 minutes?
We're watching Up.
I'm going to make you watch Up.
Oh, man.
I'm going to make you cry.
Wow. This is the big one.
Yeah.
This is the white whale. People have been wanting us to do Up for a long time. Okay.
The time has come.
I don't think I stretched my tear ducts.
Well, you're going to get a workout now.
How does one even do that? There. I think they're ready.
You did it.
And I might have burst a capillary, but here we go.
Get back in there, Tia.
I caught this in theaters with 3D glasses. And within the first 7 minutes of the film, my glasses were completely fogged up by my own eyes.
Have you been to the Up House in Salt Lake? So in Salt Lake City, Utah, some people built a house that's just the Up House.
Oh,
it doesn't have all the balloons, but everything else is like the exact same.
Oh, seeing him being the one struggling up the hill is foreshadowing, and I already know, and I'm starting to cry, because later it's her.
Get out of here, Satan.
So emotional vulnerability is Satan. Gotcha.
That's on brand for me, right?
Yeah.
That's 9 babies. And hi, Michael Giacchino.
Oh my gosh, I'm crying now.
Just a key change and an instrument change, and Michael Giacchino wrecks you.
And she sits with such dignity. Oh man, but the room's so colorful and they're so happy, and then it's the cold sterility of the doctor's office and her face and her hands. It's just, what a masterclass in nonverbal.
Listen, this is one of the greatest films ever made, and it's a short film inside of another film. I love his smile and shrug with his broken leg. Also, every viewer outside of the U.S. is like, why did you have to break open your piggy bank to do that?
The whole life.
All the ties.
Never made it to Paradise Falls.
It's where she always wanted to go since she was a kid. She was gonna have in her life, and in his mind, she didn't get to have him. Oh my gosh. Oh man.
That transition is just. And this whole thing is just a masterclass. Why are you crying and I'm not? I mean, I do.
You are. Up is my kryptonite, man.
Well, we figured it out.
We've watched movies together where I cried as much or almost as much as you.
For sure, yeah.
But never more than you.
I don't think so. This is new and exciting.
Probably because it makes me think of my parents.
Oh, there you go. Tell me about that. Got him.
Got him.
Alan usually says it, but I'll say it. Damn you, Pixar. Such a beautiful story and such a beautiful life. And, you know, you watch this and you think that's what I want to create for someone, you know? Yeah. And most of us fail.
Whoa! We've just flipped roles!
Use your aggressive feelings, boy. Let the hate flow through you.
I'm supposed to be the nihilist who cries all the time, and he's supposed to be the one asking me why I feel that way.
You know what might have helped Carl navigate his grief?
A therapist.
Yes.
Well, that's great, because today's video is sponsored by BetterHelp, where he can get one. A therapist.
BetterHelp is not a crisis line.
It is not self-help.
It is professional therapy done securely online.
BetterHelp will assess your needs and match you, or you, with a therapist with whom you can start communicating in as little as 48 hours.
You can log into your account at any time to send messages to your therapist.
You can also schedule weekly voice or like video chat call things to talk to them. Did you know? You did. BetterHelp has a network of over 20,000 therapists with a broad range of expertise, which may not be available to you in your locality, like if you live on top of a waterfall.
They make it easy and free to change therapists if needed.
Because they want to make sure that you are matched with a therapist who's a good fit for you.
BetterHelp is more affordable than traditional offline therapy.
They even accept HSA benefits and have financial aid available.
Visit betterhelp.com/cinematherapy, that's better, H-E-L-P, mm-hmm. And join over 2 million people taking charge of their mental health today with the help of an experienced professional.
Click the link below and get 10% off of your first month at betterhelp.com/cinematherapy. I do not know if they're accepting talking dogs.
Not yet.
It's in the works?
Wheels are in motion. We'll see.
We're going to make promises that BetterHelp can't keep.
Yeah.
Coming soon, talking dog therapists.
But this is just so pure and wholesome and beautiful, and I just can't. I might just leave and let Alan host this episode by himself. We'll see.
Okay, well.
I'm dangling by a thread.
Welcome to the Alan Seawright Show. We're going to keep talking more about Up. Let's watch the next scene.
Give me a tissue.
Russell.
Good afternoon. My name is Russell, and I am a wilderness explorer in Tribe 54.
Slow down.
Wet Lodge 12.
Kid!
Are you in need of
any assistance? Thank you, but I don't need any help.
Ow.
Comedic timing.
Proceed.
Good afternoon.
Let's skip to the end.
See these? These are my Wilderness Explorer badges. You may notice one is missing. It's my Assisting the Elderly badge. If I get it, I will become a Senior Wilderness Explorer. The wilderness must be explored! Gah, gah! It's gonna be great. There's a big ceremony, and all the dads come, and they pin on our badges.
So, you want to assist an old person?
Yep. Then I'll be a senior wilderness explorer.
You ever heard of a snipe? Bird. Beady eyes. Every night it sneaks in my yard and gobbles my poor azaleas. I'm elderly and infirm. If only someone could help me.
Me, I'll do it.
Oh, I don't know. It's awfully crafty. You'd have to clap your hands 3 times to lure it in.
I'll find them, Mr. Fredrickson.
I think it's burrows 2 blocks down.
If you 2 blocks past... down, got it. Snipe. Here, snipey, snipey.
Bring it back here when you find it.
I go on about perfect screenplays if you've ever watched the show. This is a perfect screenplay, and here's why. That was a whole bunch of jokes, and it was a delightful scene, and it was really fun, and there was, like, tension in the scene, and then it resolved itself. So that was a good scene.
Yeah, yeah.
But every single joke in that scene set up or foreshadowed something that comes later.
Yes.
He's like, all the dads are gonna be there. He really misses his dad. He does the caca, rawr. It makes the hearing aid go, like, squeaky really loud, which is going to be useful later.
Yeah.
After a couple more jokes, BT-dubs. The snipe. The snipe turns into Kevin. Like, it is a clockwork, perfect screenplay. Not a line is wasted. Everything does something and sets up something else.
Set up, payoff, either an emotional moment or a joke.
Yeah, and sometimes both at once, which... Good God, that is hard.
Carl's in this place where he doesn't know what his life is about.
Right.
And even if he wants his life to be about anything, like, as far as he's concerned, he had his great love, he had his great life, and now he's just kind of winding down the clock.
I mean, as far as I can tell, his plan is put my house on top of Paradise Falls, ? Profit? Like, there's no...
And die.
There's no more plan there.
I think he's going there to die.
Yeah.
I think he's going there to feel close to Ellie.
He's going into the West, kids. He's going to the Grey Havens.
Let us hear it for our poor dead friend.
If you want to watch more of us absolutely self-destructing, you can on our Patreon. Mm-hmm. There's an extended director's cut with no ads and more crying and me stomping off in a rage that I'll never make a movie this good.
And on our Patreon, you get to access our episodes before they drop on YouTube.
True. Early.
Yeah, so you get early access to the extended cuts.
It's good.
So check it out right here. And so what do you do when you're in late life arrested development or any time in your life where you're thinking, the best is behind me?
Right.
And that's kind of what this story is about, is it's about Carl finding a new life without Ellie, which is something he didn't want to do. He didn't want to ever have to do, but it is what's before him. Well, people remember the opening, but there's a whole movie here, and it's all great.
Oh my gosh, Pixar physical comedy.
I think that did the trick.
It's an entire building full of Buster Keatons.
Hi, Master.
Afternoon.
Okay, comedy in films. I love banging this drum. You can tell jokes in a movie about a million different ways, right?
Mm-hmm.
The most common and frankly easiest to do, and it's not easy, but it's the easiest, is really good witty dialogue.
Yeah.
Right? You can have two people just spitting lines at each other and it's really funny. And that's great.
Yeah.
That's really good. The thing is, you can do that anywhere, right? You can do it on stage. You can do it on the radio. Like, that's not unique to film. What is unique to film is what they just did.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, we've escaped, and there's, you know, some physical comedy and stuff, and that's great. But then they did comedy with a frame, because it's on Carl. He's like, we made it! Pan over. And, oh, nope.
And there's Doug.
Pan over again. It's even worse. Come back to Carl. Ugh. That is a thing you cannot do with any other medium. And yeah. It is genius. Thank you, Pixar, for keeping the comedy fires lit. Because that is... Mwah.
Well, this movie is an emotional banquet. From the sweet and tender stuff, to the heartbreaking stuff, to the laugh out loud stuff. I mean, you feel so many things.
So the question I had for you there is, you know, Carl is obviously still in denial.
Mm-hmm.
Have you worked with people before who reality just keeps slapping them in the face and they keep not... seeing it, and how do you break through as a therapist? Because obviously he's going to have a breakthrough in a little bit.
I would say that life has a way of hitting us with something repeatedly until we learn the lesson that we were
supposed to learn from it.
Meant to learn, right?
Yeah, and if you don't want to look at like a cosmic meant to or purposeful, you could simply say causality. There are lessons that I'm not learning, so I keep having the same problem.
Yeah, well, that's a good way to look at it, too.
And until I learn the lesson. And for Carl, the lesson is you made Ellie your entire life. Mm-hmm. And you lost yourself to that relationship, not because Ellie demanded it, but because you willingly gave your entire identity to that. So when Ellie's gone, there's no more Carl. He's a shell.
Right.
And that can be anything. That could be a relationship with a parent, a relationship with a friend, with a lover. It can be a career, profession, anything that this defines me. Mm-hmm. Well, what happens if that's taken away?
Yeah.
And suddenly there's no you. And so what Carl is learning through this experience and through this adventure, because he had a life at home, and it was a beautiful life at home,
mm-hmm.
but now his life is adventure is out there, right? Yeah. Or which is what Ellie told him when he was a child.
Right.
And that it's time for him to live and to create a new life for himself and to figure out who he actually is. And Ellie will always be a part of that.
Yeah.
And she'll always probably be the most important part of that. But there's a difference between the most important part and the only part.
Okay.
And that's part of grieving is moving on. And it's hard to move on because you feel like you're betraying something or someone that meant a lot to you.
Mm-hmm.
But if that person were here in the room, they wouldn't say, yes, mourn me, mourn!
I can't, what?
You know, they would say,
I don't know, maybe they should. That was kind of...
Don't you be happy. Don't you be happy without me.
I just felt something.
They would... It was the jowl shake.
It was. Knees are like a knees.
No! Binks, you was making the life play with this a his a isn't?
Uh-huh.
What the hell's going on? I mean, what the hell is going on?
So he's finding, and life is slapping him with, wake up, you still got a life to live.
It's a talking dog.
What is a talking dog?
You should have this in your life.
Doug is amazing.
Doug is a very good boy.
Squirrel!
All done. That's
Wing!
Oh my god!
Wait, aren't you Super Wilderness Guy? With the GPMs and the badges?
Yeah, but... Can I tell you a secret?
No.
All right, here it goes.
All right, here it goes.
I never actually built a tent before. There, I said it.
You've been camping before, haven't you?
Well, never outside.
Well, why didn't you ask your dad how to build a tent?
I don't think he wants to talk about this stuff.
Why don't you try him sometime? Maybe he'll surprise you.
Well, he's away a lot. I don't see him much.
He's got to be home sometime.
Well, I called, but Phyllis told me I bug him too much.
Phyllis? You call your own mother by her first name?
Phyllis isn't my mom.
Oh.
Never even crossed his mind. And to completely rethink his paradigm.
But he promised he'd come to my Explorer ceremony to pin on my Assisting the Elderly badge. So he can show me about tents then, right?
That's why he wants it so bad.
Hey, why don't you get some sleep? Don't want to wake up the traveling flea circus.
And Carl finds...
Mr. Fredrickson? Doug says he wants to take Kevin prisoner. We have to protect him. Can Kevin go with us?
But Carl finds that maybe he can be a father after all.
Yeah. Promise you won't leave him?
Yeah.
Cross your heart?
That was set up earlier.
With Ellie, yeah.
Guys, it's a good, it's a well-written movie.
Cross my heart. What have I got myself into, Ellie?
And if you think you're at a place where you don't need anybody anymore, maybe that's true, but there are people who need you.
Yep.
You know?
Also, it's not true. Just throwing that out there.
Yeah. The way that Russell needs him, without saying that he needs him.
Well, because he, A, probably doesn't know, and B, wouldn't be comfortable sharing that anyway. I mean, such good writing because it's such true human emotion. How many times in life have you walked up to somebody and just been like, all cards on the table, I need you.
Yeah, like twice.
Yeah, like it just doesn't happen very much.
Yeah. When you lose someone, like the most important person in the world to you, whether it's through death or a breakup or you move away, like we can get into this headspace of there will never be someone else like this for me. And so I won't
even try. I've
lost
something permanently.
Yeah.
There will never be a replacement. Nothing can ever be the same. Yeah.
And that's true. There's no one to replace my mom, for example. But does that mean I don't have new attachments and I don't form new connections and I don't find value and joy in that? Carl's not especially looking to get married again. Okay.
Yeah.
But he needed a friend.
Yeah.
You know, and in this case, needed to be a father figure. I'm going to always move forward.
You know what, Mr. Fredrickson? The wilderness isn't quite what I expected.
Yeah? How so?
It's kind of wild. I mean, it's not how they made it sound in my book.
Get used to that, kid.
My dad made it sound so easy. He's really good at camping and how to make fire from rocks and stuff. He used to come to all my sweat lodge meetings. And afterwards, we'd go get ice cream at Fenton's. I always get chocolate and he gets butterbrickle. Then we sit on this one curb right outside, and I'll count all the blue cars and he counts all the red ones. And whoever gets the most wins. I like that curb. That might sound boring, but I think the boring stuff is the stuff I remember the most.
It's really just about the time.
Yeah.
You know, taking the time to connect, taking the time to... And a lot of what they call the Disneyland dads or the Disneyland moms, they're almost never there, and then when they do, they sweep in with presents and some big grand gesture.
And
what is needed is just consistency. It's the little things consistently. That's how you build a relationship with someone.
Yeah. I legitimately want to know who animated. I don't know if it was the whole scene or if they just did that shot between the actor delivering, I like that curb, and then the animation of Russell saying that, realizing what he's said, which is, I miss my dad, and then looking down.
No.
Thank you. Oh, this is... Here we go.
Oh, this is my favorite part of the movie.
I think this is the part where I break in half and you actually explain things.
Gosh, it's so heartbreaking. She never got to do all the stuff she wanted to do. He feels like he failed her.
So this is... I don't even want to call it a trick, but this is a technique that Michael Giacchino, the composer, uses a lot.
Mm-hmm.
He'll take a happy theme from whatever show he's working on. In this case, the Married Life theme. He'll transpose the key to a minor key, play it slow, and then he'll hesitate.
Like the note should...
slightly too long, and then...
Like the note should arrive sooner, yeah.
Da, 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 da. Bum, bum, bum. Bum, bum. Like, he's slow on it.
Yeah.
And it just, it pulls the emotion out of you.
The thing I love about Ellie is that she's always got so much dignity, you know?
But not in a stuffy way.
Yeah.
Look at that animation of his chin quivering, his big giant stepladder chin.
Thanks for the adventure, now go have a new one.
Crap. Damn it, Pixar. You got both of us.
And I love that you could see the little boy still in his face. When he's frowning, he doesn't look like the little boy. But when he's looking at this and he smiles, you see young Carl again.
Third time. Cross his heart.
Oh my gosh.
Well, you did it, Pixar. You broke both of us. We're just done.
I actually won't make too many notes on that. I think the scene speaks for itself, especially given the conversations we've had. But everyone talks about the opening montage, and nobody talks about that scene.
Yeah.
And that scene, to me, hits just as hard.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe even harder. Yeah. Like, the opening scene breaks my heart, but
wouldn't hit at all if it wasn't for the opening scene.
Right. I'm more likely to cry when something is tender and beautiful than when something is sad.
Yeah.
Of course, Up gets me with both of them.
Up gets you with all 9 barrels.
And whenever people talk about Up, they're like, oh, that opening is so sad and so devastating. And I don't know why people aren't talking about the beautiful catharsis of...
Yeah.
Especially because the end of the opening montage is her sliding him the book.
Giving him the book.
Like, in the hospital bed. Because she knew that would be healing for him. And like a dummy, he didn't look at it.
Like a blockhead. Literal blockhead.
But just how important it is to keep living. And to find new people to live for. And new experiences to live for.
Yeah.
You know, whatever you've lost, whatever opportunity, whatever person. You know, you think that, well, that was it. That was my life. There's nothing to look forward to now. There is. You probably don't see it yet, but it's there. Adventure is out there, right? Hope is out there.
For assisting the elderly.
The choice to keep him all dirty from Paradise Falls, like they just got here.
I'm here for him.
Congratulations, Russell.
A smile on his face.
Russell, for assisting the elderly, and for performing above and beyond the call of duty.
And there's that theme again.
To award you the highest honor I can bestow. The Ellie badge.
Wow.
Covers everybody. So let's give
How can your heart not be warmed?
To our brand new senior wilderness explorer.
Just picturing freaking gladiator. Is your heart not warmed?
Is your soul not moistened?
What the hell did you just say?
Nope. It isn't. That was gross.
I'm gonna veto that right now.
We've gotten the veto from the producer.
You're fired.
Whoa! That was it. Crap, I need to find a new co-host. I don't know why, but that was it.
You are made of stupid.
What a freaking masterpiece.
It's listen, there are perfect movies, and this is one of them.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, Pixar, and everyone who put work into this. This is a very healing movie for me. Always has been. Came out...
I think it was 09.
09, yeah.
Yeah, so just a couple years after your mom passed.
A couple years after my mom passed. It was and continues to be... Something that touches me, moves me, helps me to heal, helps me to look forward, helps me to still live. And for those of you who are watching who feel like you can't go on because of what or who you've lost, adventure is out there, you know?
Yeah.
The hope is out there, the life is out there, it's time to discover it. So until next time,
but it's a talking dog!
My master made me this collar so that I may squirrel. Hi there.
And watch movies!
Thanks to all you patrons who support our show.
This week we're especially thanking Andrew Feisner, Ashley Darch, Sarah Brandt, Wesley Gunder, and Skylar Anderson. You're great. You're all great, but especially you are great.
You know who you are. Oh, Wesley. You were going to single him out. Okay.
Wesley Gunders. He knows what he did.